I would like to share with you seven Ramadan habits of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When iftar time comes, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what does he say? لَا يَزَالُ النَّاسُ بِخَيْرٍ مَا عَجَّلُ الْفِطْرِ. You will be in a good shape. Allah will bless you. Allah will honor you. As an ummah, as a family, as an individual, if you hasten in breaking your fast. Rasulullah sallallahu says from the sunnah of Ummat Muhammad, تعجيل الفطر. You go right away when you break your fast. In another narration, Rasulullah sallallahu gives you a illah, a reason. One of the reasons behind that, he said, لِأَنَّ الْيَهُودَ وَالنَّصَارَى يُؤَخِّرُونَ. He says the Yahud and the Christians and the Jews, they tend to postpone, delay their breaking of their fast. Whether it's applied today or not, it doesn't matter to you or to me. Rasulullah says, hasten, we hasten. عليه الصلاة والسلام. So do I go full-fledged iftar? Like, or what do I do? From the sunnah of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that when Maghrib time comes, right away he breaks his fast with tumayrat or tamarat, some dates. If he could not find dates, hasa hasawatin min ma, he would take some sips of water, then he prays sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alright, so whatever your family would like to have full-fledged iftar or just a few bites, may Allah bless you, protect you, just make sure you don't postpone Maghrib very late. Alhamdulillah, we have arranged. That was the sunnah and the habit of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when it comes to iftar, breaking the fast. Habit number two, which is dua. Dua, and specifically at iftar time. We have two for you. One general and one specific. Dhikr muqayyad, which is Rasulullah sallam saying, ذهب الظما, the thirst is gone. So he eats, he drinks, then he says, ذهب الظما, the thirst is gone. وابتلت العروق, and the veins are moist. وَثَبَتَ الْأَجْرُ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ, and the reward is guaranteed by the will of Allah. This was Rasulullah's dua, one of them that he says at iftar time. He appreciates the ni'mah. I have food, I have drink, alhamdulillah. Then look at his attitude. We should be like that, inshallah. Then he says, وَثَبَتَ الْأَجْرُ, he's optimistic. I worked hard, I sacrificed hours of sweat and the heat of the sun. I'm optimistic. That's the mu'min. I worked hard. أَنَا مُتَفَائِلْ. ثَبَتَ الْأَجْرُ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ. That's the attitude of the believer. May Allah make us of that category. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Then the other type of dua, ready for this? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, now habit number two, dua. ثَلَاثَةٌ لَا تُرَدُّ دَعْوَتُهُمْ. Three groups of people, their dua is never rejected. Allahu Akbar. One of them was صَائِمُ حَتَّى يُفْطِر. The one who's fasting until they break their fast. Tough question. Just came up 2 days ago. Do I make the dua before the adhan or after the adhan? No problem. Either options work, inshallah. If you wish to do it right before, go for it. May Allah grant you barakah and don't forget us in your dua. If you want to do it after, alhamdulillah is also khair. So make sure, inshallah, especially with sometimes our mothers or sisters, if they're preparing things, our fathers every now and then, no need to pressure, like, no, stop cooking, stop everything. You have to make dua right now. No. You make dua, you're a bit relaxed. Maybe to them it will be better right after iftar. Whatever works within that time period, may Allah allow us to follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's two. Number three, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it comes to donations. You said something, seven Ramadan habits. What does donations have to do with it? Rasulullah used to always donate. That is true. But his donation level in Ramadan was unheard of. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was said about him, كَانَ أَجْوَدَ النَّاسِ. يعني no one in the world was as generous as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Unbelievable. Unmatched. Can you imagine that level? Then the hadith says, وَكَانَ أَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونْ فِي رَمَضَانِ. But his generosity, it takes like a whole other level in Ramadan. Allahu Akbar. So as good as he was throughout the year in Ramadan, he took it to the next level. So now inshallah, my suggestion, this is not from the sunnah, is to actually withdraw some cash. I know you have debit cards, credit cards, all the good stuff, Venmo, Zelle, all the good stuff, but having cash sometimes very quick and accessible. And sometimes like, oh, I wish I had this. And it says another hadith, very interesting. كَرِّيحِ الْمُرْسَلَ. He was like the very like quick wind. And one of the meanings of his generosity being like the wind does not go in like one direction, only this way. No, the wind goes this way, goes a little bit this way. So one of the meanings of it is that he serves in all good causes. عليه الصلاة والسلام. So once again, may Allah allow us to follow the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We spoke about his iftar, we spoke about dua at iftar, and now we spoke about donation. Number four out of seven, brothers and sisters, is his Quran recitation. Quran recitation. In the authentic narration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was said about him, وَكَانَ يُدَارِسُهُ جِبْرِيلُ. Jibreel alayhi salam used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi وسلم يدارسه ويراجع معه القرآن وذلك كل ليلة. Every single night, Jibril comes, reviews the Quran at night time. And what does review the Quran? Looking into the meaning and the tafsir of the hadith, it says he used to review his memorization of it. That's one of the meanings, al-hifz. And the question comes, brother, in Ramadan, do I read more? Well, do I contemplate more? And there's a big discussion. كله خير إن شاء الله. But you notice that at bare minimum, make sure that you read and you read and you read as much as you possibly can. You want to add to that tafsir, look at a surah today, inshallah, this year, Ramadan, I'm going to focus very much on Juz' al-Amma as in understanding it. Great. But don't, my nasiha, don't let that stop you from reading the Quran. Because many of the narrations of the, let's say, sahaba, ulama, it was like how frequently they read the Quran. So may Allah grant us understanding of the Quran and application of it. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. And your Quran in Ramadan is one of the most important things. Because what made Ramadan special was the Quran. Excuse me? What made Ramadan Ramadan was the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. What made Ramadan so special is the fact that Quran descended in that month. So your relationship with it should be to the next level. Again, about this point with the Quran, taking it from the hadith, you notice Rasulullah ﷺ had a companion, had Jibreel عليه السلام. So one of the things that perhaps may help us with finishing the Quran, reviewing it at a consistent basis, is having good company. Maybe having a WhatsApp group of wonderful people, having a majlis in the masjid. Just try to perhaps work with some people if you need the extra motivation and to help you with words here and there. This is all from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Number five, brothers and sisters, is the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam's qiyam, his night prayers. What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam say? Man qama Ramadan, whoever stands up during the nights of Ramadan, imanan wahtisaba, out of faith and out of hope in getting the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know what happens? غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. All the sins that you've done, all the previous ones are erased. What should you do? Don't miss a single night in Ramadan. May Allah make it possible for all of us, Ya Rabbi. And Allah is capable of fulfilling this dua. Every night. Tayyib brother, give us some tips that Rasulullah ﷺ advised us to be able to fulfill this. Ready? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم إنه من قام مع الإمام حتى ينصرف كتب له قيام ليلة. Rasulullah ﷺ, some people like want to wonder about Taraweeh and how it was established. There's a lot of detail which we will not get into right now. But Rasulullah ﷺ did establish a congregation, Jama'at Qiyam al-Layl, in his masjid in Medina. And there were nights that he did not do it. So one time, it was brought to the Prophet's attention, you know, if we can pray longer, right? More and more. Because when they want to get the reward of Qiyam al-Layl. Look what the Prophet said. Whoever prays Jama'ah at night, in our situation like Taraweeh, and leaves when the imam is done, kutibat lahu qiyamul, you got that check, you fulfilled the night prayers, done, one down, 29 left inshallah, right? And I'll be very honest with you, I hope this was made clear, because when I heard this hadith, I thought, and I was a lot younger, I thought when the imam is done, hatta yansarif means when the imam leaves. So I actually used to wait in the lobby of the masjid after Taraweeh until the imam goes back to his car. May Allah forgive us and grant us guidance, Ya Rab. What it meant is that when he's done with the salah, then you can go ahead and Qiyam al-Layl is written for you. May Allah make it possible for all of us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. The sixth one, Sahur. Sahur. I know people have different styles, different, you know, schedules and so on. But let me tell you the Rasulullah ﷺ's habit and sunnah when it comes to Sahur. Two hadith. Number one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السَّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. He says, make sure you have sahur. Sahur is the meal right before fajr, at the sahur time, waqt al-sahur. Even if it was a little bit, because there's barakah. There's barakah. And when Rasulullah says barakah, what does barakah mean? Okay, you drank some water. Generally speaking, when you drink water, for example, it makes you not thirsty, for example, for 3 hours. If you drink water, it will not make you thirsty for 3 hours. For example, if Allah were to put barakah in that water, you will go for 6 hours without being thirsty. This is an example of the meaning of barakah. So when Rasulullah ﷺ says, تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السَّحُورِ بَرَكَةً, means you would eat that food, and that food, there's barakah in it. It will make you last longer. You just fill gas for $5, but it took you to Ohio. That's an example of barakah. Literally, this is what barakah would mean. May Allah put barakah in your health, in your wealth, in your family, in your life and in your deen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. طب look at Rasulullah Sallam, look how much he encourages people to do suhoor. He says, تسحروا, in another hadith, تسحروا ولو بجرعة ماء فإن الله وملائكته يصلون على المتسحرين. والله, that hadith is enough. It's enough, wallahi. Look what that translation is. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, have suhoor, even if it was just a little bit of water. Allah and the malaika, they pray for the one who performs that suhoor, who fulfills it. May Allah make us of those who Allah and the angels pray for. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. Now we go to the seventh and last one, brothers and sisters, which is the akhlaq of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We spoke about actions and so on, which is wonderful in terms of the ibadat, but there's also of the mu'amalat. He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, whoever comes to you, أحد شاتمك أو قاتلك, someone tries to curse at you, fight you, have an argument with you, you know, cause disturbance with you. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what does he say? Tell and say, إني صائم, إني صائم. That's your response. Someone says, oh, you're such and such and such. إني صائم, إني صائم. I'm fasting. No response. Don't get into this. It's Ramadan. You know, we say, people would say, showtime. This is like ibadah time. I'm not, I don't have time for arguing and fighting. إني صائم, إني صائم. This was the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Seven Ramadan habits of the Prophet that I pray to Allah to allow you and I to be able to fulfill them. Ameen Rabbil Alameen.